When Mary was 49 years old, she noticed some unusual lumps in her breasts. Over time, these lumps got larger and developed painful lesions that seeped fluid. As her condition worsened, she began having troubles breathing, and because of this, she was unable to do some of her daily activities, like working and going on walks. After her condition got out of hand, she decided to go to the doctor and was diagnosed with stage 4 breast cancer. In stage 4 breast cancer, the cancer has spread into the lymph nodes and into other places in the body like the lungs, liver, and bones. Mary had the BRCA mutation. BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutations account for about 20 to 25% of hereditary breast cancers and 5 to 10% of all breast cancers. We are going to focus on just the BRCA1 mutation. BRCA1 is a tumor suppressor gene expressed in breast tissue that helps repair damaged DNA. When this protein is mutated, it is unable to properly repair the damaged DNA, increasing the chances of developing cancerous cells. BRCA1 is described as the breast cancer susceptibility protein. There are hundreds of different deletions and variations of sequence within the BRCA gene that cause the mutation to occur. Deletion mutations occur when part of the DNA molecule is not copied during replication. These mutations can occur at all parts of the chromosome. It was reported that the mutation spectrum of BRCA1 is found from PCR-based mutation screening methods. Some of these methods are SSCP, protein truncation tests, and direct sequencing using genomic DNA as a sequence. BRCA1 contains a ring domain that consists of two flanking alpha helices, a ring finger, and an amino acid motif that binds two zinc ions that stabilize the structure. The alpha helices are responsible for the interaction of BRCA1 with BARD1, which is an important BRCA1 binding partner. BARD1 is only one of many proteins that interact with BRCA1. P53 is another protein that is common in interacting with the BRCA1 gene. Overexpression of BRCA1 can induce apoptosis, which leads to a programmed cell death. Apoptosis may be involved with or without BRCA1 mutations, but 3 mutations of the BRCA1 gene were identified with positive apoptosis samples. Although there is no cure for the BRCA1 mutation, PARP inhibitors can help to treat it. PARP inhibitors block the repair of DNA damage and have been found to arrest the growth of cancer cells that have BRCA1 or BRCA2 mutations. If the PARP enzyme was blocked, there would be breaks in the DNA that could not be repaired properly, and those breaks could be fatal to cancer cells. Olaparib is a part of the group of PARP inhibitors that acts against cancers caused by BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutations. The use of this drug could slow the growth of cancers by 3 months and is less toxic than radiation and chemotherapy. About 60% of patients with BRCA mutation saw their tumors shrink with the use of olaparib.